Swanjay here with Bellis Lawn and Gardens, and today I'm on a gutter downspout drainage system install and also one catch basin. We're going to tie in these two gutter downspouts and also install a catch basin, and we've already run into a problem. This is where our catch basin was going to go originally, and we were going to put it there so that we could capture as much water as possible that is shedding off of this hillside. And then where that catch basin was going to sit, I was going to put a piece of 4-inch metal edging behind it in an L shape. It'd go this way, then come up this way. That would allow me to bring the grade up over here and grade it towards the catch basin. That way we're catching a lot of water, a lot more water, surface water, and getting it directed into this area, into that catch basin. Well, we ran into a problem down there by the second gutter downspout. There's an overpour cement or something, we don't know what, but it's thick. It's like 4 inches thick. We can't break it. We don't know if we should break it. We don't know if it has something to do with the retainer wall, so we're just going to leave it. Now, that makes us change our design of our system. We've actually stepped the catch basin up here, because the majority of the water is running down the backside of this retainer wall. And before I backfilled all that, you could see where it's just taken all that out. It's washed everything out there. So we're gonna put it here. And I'm gonna cut that piece of metal edging and put it around the catch basin so that I can backfill that area right there against the catch basin. And also that'll help prevent any water from overspilling from the catch basin, so we're making sure we're getting all the water directed into it. Important thing whenever you are installing a drainage system, it's important to remember this, is that your first 10 feet, preferably your first 20 feet, but absolutely your first 10 feet should have the maximum slope allowed for the site that you're working on. And if you do that, as you continue to work your system down to the discharge area, you can start to level it out. So if you have a 3% slope in the first 10 to 20 feet of your system, and then you start to level your pipe out, you're gonna get really good movement, water movement through the system, and you're still gonna get good water push out. So it's important, remember those first 10 to 20 feet, get as much slope as possible. And that's what we're gonna have to do here, because down there, that's as far as we can dig. So here, the discharge line will actually remain above grade, and then I'm gonna make sure that I get as much slope as possible, because all through there, from about 2 feet past that gutter downspout right there, that's basically gonna end up almost level until I get to that second gutter downspout, and then I can start to drop again. But if I've got good fall here in the first 10 to 20 feet, you're gonna be fine. Okay, so I've installed my metal edging. You can see it right here. And I'll pick up a piece of rebar. I don't have a piece with me, but I've gotta go to Lowe's. I've gotta get some more fittings. But I'll get a piece of rebar and get it behind that so it pushes nice and flush up against that catch basin right there. Now, whenever we talk about bringing a catch basin to grade, this is what I'm talking about. I don't know if you'll be able to tell in the video. Let's see if I can get, but you can see that's higher on that side. This is higher, and then everything comes slanting towards the grate of the catch basin. That's what we mean whenever we're saying bring something to grade. And the reason we want to do that, especially this way, almost create like a bowl effect, is there's a lot of water coming down the backside of this retainer wall. We don't want to give it the opportunity to bypass our catch basin, so we build it up higher. That way it'll flow in and go into our catch basin and down into our system. So now what I'm going to do is tie into this catch basin right here and start running my my discharge line, and pick up that gutter downspout right there and tie into it too. Okay, Brooks Blanchet here again, and I'm getting ready to tie my gutter downspout into my discharge line. Got my T right there, and I wanted to show you the way that I like to check my slope whenever I'm working with PVC pipe, solid PVC pipe. Understand that solid PVC pipe is not as forgiving as corrugated pipe is whenever you're installing it into the bottom of your trench. If you got humps and bumps and rocks throughout the bottom of your trench and you're laying corrugated pipe, it easily just lays right over it and you continue to lay it. PVC pipe, anything like that, is going to throw your slope off. So I just use a torpedo level, just set it on there, and you want to be sure, so long as your bubble is all the way to the back, you know that you've got a minimum of 1% slope. Okay, so we got our gutter downspout tied in down there. Now we're going to tie this one in, and what you need is a way, because we're going to go from the gutter downspout from that discharge line into the way and then out to one discharge line. So what you need right there is a 45, and that should, and that 45, slide it back some and it'll line up perfect, or you can slide it this way, either way. Stop that truck. That's funny. Alright, so anyway, we're gonna take we're gonna take a 45 angle into it, come straight off of the gutter downspout, then straight in a PVC pipe. Probably have to put a 22 there to get around that corner, another 22, and then straight down. Okay, here we go. We got both lines tied in. We got a lot of our line buried now, still got a little bit more to go. Got to get around this bend right here in the trench. So what we do here is we just want to take our fitting, you know, once you do this a couple of times you'll get the hang of it, but I can tell that a 22 would be perfect here. So I get a 22, I look, set it on the pipe right here, check my trench, see where it's going to line up, make sure everything's going to line up. Here you really don't need a measuring tape, you just need to eyeball it. Once you do it a couple times, you'll get better at it. Let's look, right there work. So I'm just gonna mark it. That's my mark right there. I'm gonna go grab my saw and cut it. Here we are, pretty much all done with this job. Actually, I finished it a day or two ago, and I maintain this property, I mow it, so had to come back out here. Needed to put a little topsoil down there. Kind of strange, usually I don't run out of soil, but I didn't have enough. So, and this right here is why I like to use a mini X on this job. It's not perfect, but I feel it's a lot better had I used a trencher, because usually when you backfill it, you leave a mound, and using a trencher allows you to pull all that dirt back into your trench, and then I just grade it, just run it over. And you know, that Bermuda right there, this time of year especially, it'll grow right back through there. Throw a little straw in there just in case it rains, so your dirt don't run all down the road. But other than that, they are good to go, and we're done here. Thanks for watching. Any questions, any comments, as always, leave them below.